look at this crowd. More than 30,000 have made their way to the streets of South Point and Durham tonight as we're about to kick off the holiday season in a big way with the lighting of the NBC 17 Tree of Lights. But before we flip the switch, we've got some outstanding entertainment, beginning with Sony recording artist, singer, songwriter, Cheyenne Kimball.
Special guest pop sensation Cheyenne Kimball. Also tonight, Santa Claus will join us to help light the NBC 17 Tree of Lights. Now, here are Melanie Sanders and Wes Hohenstein.
Hello, everyone. I'm Melanie Sanders.
And I'm Wes Hohenstein. Thanks for joining us on this chilly night here in Durham. That was Cheyenne Kimball singing her new song, Breaking Your Heart. And Melanie, she is not the only person out there. We got a few people behind us. Look at this crowd. Everyone out here ready to watch the lighting of our 50-foot Norwegian spruce right behind us and ring in the holiday season.
And for the people here at the streets at South Point, and for those of you at home, you are in for a treat. We have more performances by Cheyenne, but first we want to check in with Bill Ray. Hey, Bill.
Hey, Wes. Hey, Melanie. Hey, everybody. I'm on the stage that's going to host the 82nd Airborne All-American Chorus, King's Choir. We got a great stage here. CC and Company and their fan club, and also Theater in the Park. So we've got a great time planned for you. This is the stage for us, and we're going to have a great time. The crowd is beautiful out here, and there's a lot of nice warmth in this crowd despite the cold temperatures. And out somewhere in that crowd is Kim Gennardo. Kim.
Good evening, everyone. I'm Kim Gennardo. Happy holidays. Look at this good-looking group of Christmas princesses I have up here with me. We have got the best spot here. We are right in front of our 50-foot tree, which will be lit in about an hour and a half, and we hope you have a good time with us. We're gonna send it over to Donald and Sharon to help get us in the holiday spirit. Hi, guys.
Hey!
Hi!
Woo!
I think we have a good stage. What do you think?
Oh, yeah!
Good evening, everybody. I'm Donald Jones.
And I'm Sharon Tazewell. Enjoying the concert so far. All right. We're on the John Hancock stage, and this is where Cheyenne Kimball's performing. She's getting ready to perform some more songs. You like that? Yeah.
So what do you think? Is the crowd ready for Cheyenne? Well, let's bring her right up here for a second.
Well, you know what? Before she sings, we have to get to know her just a little bit, right?
Yeah, we got to fill the fans in on a few secrets or something like that. So first off, Cheyenne, it's the holidays, so you're making your list, right?
I am.
What's top on your list?
Top on my list. You know, I'm always on tour, and I'm always having to capture some amazing things that go on in my life, so I really need a camera, actually, a new digital camera.
A new digital camera to take pictures of all our great fans.
Great idea. Great idea. Hey, I know your family. You guys just moved to Nashville, and you said that you celebrate Christmas. So do you have a tradition that y'all do?
You know, it's really funny. We get to open up one present on Christmas Eve because we open everything else Christmas morning really early. And we all get to open up a robe and pajamas and slippers so that we're all set, you know, for New Year's Eve. And we're all like decked out in our new pajamas. It's all fun.
Oh, that sounds fabulous. And Cheyenne's going to sing another song for us.
Right, and to give us a little bit more in the holiday spirit here at the NBC 7 Tree of Lights, what are you going to sing for us?
I'm going to sing White Christmas.
All right, everybody, Cheyenne Kimball!
I'm dreaming of a world.
All right, Cheyenne, great job on White Christmas. She'll be back to sing more later. Don't worry about that. And by the way, I have a camera for her if she wants that for maybe an early Christmas present.
Stay with NBC 17 Tree of Light special right here at the streets of South Point. We'll be right back.
When NBC 17's Tree of Lights continues, we'll meet the star of tonight's show and the King's Choir of Durham performs.
At 7 p.m.
At 7.
At 7 p.m.
At 7.
At 7 p.m. on NBC 17.
At 7.
Watch NBC 17, you're laughing in the triangle.
7 p.m.
7 p.m.
7 p.m. 7 p.m. 7 p.m. 7 p.m.
7 p.m.
7 p.m. 7
p.m. 7 p.m.
Your local news. Your local news at 7.
On NBC 17.
Now there's one full hour of local news and weather plus forecasts when you're home to watch.
7 p.m.
And that's worth singing about.
What a great crowd we have out here for the NBC 17 Tree of Lights at the streets at South Point, all of whom seem to be in the holiday spirit.
You know, I thought the cold weather might keep them quiet, but they are definitely a loud crowd. And, of course, being around the holidays, holiday means it's giving time. That's part of the holiday spirit. And throughout the holidays, you can actually bring an unwrapped toy here to the mall as part of the Toys for Tots campaign. And while here, you'll have to check out the spectacular view of that big tree behind us.
NBC 17's Frank Graff introduces us to the man who cut and decorated the Tree of Lights, as well as trees for cities nationwide.
The first time I did it, you know, the guy called me and asked me if I would ever cut a 45-foot tree, and I said no. And I said, have you ever decorated one? And he said, no. He said, well, I guess we're in the same boat.
Pick up on it.
Take your time.
23 years after cutting his first giant tree, Wayne Holden's starting another holiday season, carefully cutting a Norwegian spruce.
Close to 50 foot.
He's gifted with an eye for finding perfect giant trees. It's a full-time job now, scouting the mountains, cutting, shipping, decorating trees around the country. This was an abandoned nursery near Pinola.
You start out with a good tree to begin with, and then it makes decorating a lot easier. When you land on the project with a pretty tree, you know, everybody says, wow, you know, that's a good tree. You're okay.
The tree is tied to a crane.
How many people get to do this? I mean, how many 47-year-old man do you know can climb a tree?
Then cut and guided by ropes and hanging by a cable, 4,000 pounds of needles and wood gently settles to earth.
They're down.
I just got to watch the top, make sure it don't break, you know, when you get on the ground. Or put too much pressure and it breaks.
Everybody clear?
Yeah.
Everybody clear. 31,
32, 33, 34, 35, 36. Counting the rings, the tree was about 36 years old. Norwegian spruces grow between 24 and 36 inches a year.
Okay. I like that.
Then that 36-foot-wide tree is wrapped to a quarter of its size for shipping.
It's still a little fun. You just get different places, different trees.
Come down. I'm holding. Come out.
Then guided into a custom-made stand, it towers again. It's leveled, secured, and transformed into a tree of lights with 6,000 pounds of decorations.
And it's fun to know that as many people that cruise by that tree, and it's nice to know, say, man, hey, I did that, you know. So it's kind of cool.
In Pinola, North Carolina, Frank Graff, NBC 17 News.
All right, Frank, thank you very much. Melanie, I thought Norwegian spruce, I thought we got it from Norway, but we got it here.
They grow them right here in North Carolina. And it has been a busy month for Wayne and his crew. Besides the Tree of Lights behind us, they're cutting and delivering 20 other giant trees around the country.
Yeah, and as we continue to count down to the lighting of the tree, we want to get a little more in the holiday spirit. So let's get some more music. Joining us now is the King's Choir, and they're singing Joy.
Yeah.
James and Jackie White. James is the pastor of the Life Community Church in Durham.
Associate pastor.
What is the your chorus, your choir, what does it provide the community?
Well, it is our vision of our pastor, Dr. Kingsley Fletcher at Life Community Church, to reach out. We're a community church. Actually, a church where the nation gathers is our motto. A lot of different nationalities, so it provides.
Wow, now these guys are good, right? They have traveled the world. Where have you been lately?
Well, lately we've had this past June we had an opportunity to go to Ghana, West Africa, which is the homeland of our pastor, and this month we had an opportunity to go to Winterthur, Switzerland. So we've had some tremendous opportunities.
All right, and I know y'all want to hear them again. They will be back later in the show tonight. So stick around for that, but right now we're going back to Melanie and Wes.
Wow, I tell you, if you weren't awake before they sang, you're awake now.
Absolutely. Their music fills the soul. They were fantastic. Well, the holiday season is also about sharing, and one way you can do that is by donating blood.
That's right. It's during this time of year when people become busy and blood donations hit a critically low point. But Kim Gennardo showed us why donating can be the key to survival.
Many parents and children know George Allman as their pediatrician. But almost 5 years ago, Dr. Allman went from physician to patient.
I had leukemia almost 5 years ago, and I had 40 blood transfusions. I had 30 platelet transfusions.
There are so many patients in this area that would not be able to celebrate the holidays with their families if they did not receive these blood transfusions.
Ann cleverly manages the Rex Hospital Blood Services office. She says one donor can help up to three people, and Dr. Allman is grateful to each person who helped him.
Those people are heroes. They take an hour, and they do something which helps a lot of people.
Joining me now is Brian Smith from Rex Hospital. If you were out here earlier today, you might have noticed you guys had a blood drive here.
Yes, Kim, indeed we did, a very successful one. I'd like to thank all that donated for their gift tonight.
And Brian, this time of year, a lot of times our blood supply is of critical shortage. Is it because we all get so busy, we're traveling, and you don't have as many donors?
That certainly is one factor. Plus, unfortunately, sickness does not take a holiday break. And so I'd like to challenge all the people in the audience this evening and those watching at home that as you get into the holiday spirit, to please, as you're buying gifts for your family and your friends, to please give a gift to a stranger and donate blood. It's always the right color and the right size, and the recipient was very appreciative.
Thank you, Brian. Have a wonderful holiday yourself and doing the good work for us at Rex Hospital. And NBC 17's Tree of Lights will be right back.
Next on NBC 17's Tree of Lights, the 82nd Airborne All-American Chorus takes the stage. Don't go away.
And we are back getting ready to light the NBC 17 Christmas tree at the streets at South Point. And there's a shot of your crowd, and they are excited. We are getting pretty close. There's a shot of Maggiano's, one of the many fine restaurants here in Durham at the streets at South Point. Boy, some Italian food sure would warm things up tonight.
Absolutely.
We're getting close to lighting up the tree. You can tell by the crowd. And by my watch, Melanie, I'd say we're just about 60 minutes away from flipping the switch.
That's right. It's a beautiful tree, too. We cannot wait to light it. And, of course, everybody's getting excited. Are we getting excited? Yeah, the crowd is enjoying themselves, having so much fun. Let's toss it over to Kim Gennardo, who is in the midst of all the excitement. Hey, Kim.
Hi, Melanie. I hope you guys are getting in the holiday spirit. Look at this good group of people I have up here with me. Isn't this awesome? Sherry, where are you from?
Chapel Hill.
I'm stuck here with my mic. Let's go over here. Marquise, where are you from?
I'm from Germany.
You're from Germany?
Yeah.
What are you doing in Durham, North Carolina?
Well, I moved here.
Well, okay, yeah, because you can't just drive to Germany, can you? Well, welcome to Durham. How about you, sweetheart? What's your name?
I'm Laura, and I'm from Rocky Mount.
All right, Rocky Mount, Durham, Chapel Hill. We've got you all represented. Now let's go over to Donald and Sharon on the John Hancock stage.
Hey, all right.
How are you?
Thank you, Kim. Thank you. Everybody's having a great time here tonight. Thousands of people enjoying the celebration. But unfortunately, you know what? unfortunately, not all the time our loved ones, we can spend so much time with them during the holidays.
That's right. It can be difficult if you have someone who suffers from dementia or Alzheimer's. But that's why a local company and a nonprofit agency are getting together to make things easier.
On November 1st, family and friends honored those affected by Alzheimer's disease with candlelight reflections.
Candles were burning in about 105 different areas of North Carolina. And we were excited about this because this was the first collaborative effort connecting the Division of Aging, the Alzheimer's chapters, and the Duke Family Program.
Alice Watkins heads up the Alzheimer's Association Eastern North Carolina chapter. Her organization helps the thousands of families who are dealing with this disease. John Hancock Financial Services also helped these families by discussing their options, such as long-term care insurance. But for some John Hancock employees, their assistance is personal.
We've also had experiences with our own families, and it's a one way to kind of give back to the community and team up with the North Carolina Alzheimer's Association.
And we are out here again on the John Hancock Financial Network stage. Joining me, Robert Turner with John Hancock Financial Services, as well as Alice Watkins. She's with the Alzheimer's Association Eastern North Carolina chapter. And John, I believe you have a nice gift for Alice.
Yes, I do. I'm very proud on the behalf of John Hancock Financial Network here in the Triangle to present a check for $4,000 to the Alzheimer's Association.
Wonderful. And what a wonderful partnership you have. I'm sure this money will come in very handy.
Absolutely.
Alice, please tell us about your partnership with John Hancock.
Yes. I think one of the nice things in doing this tonight is that long-term care insurance is so important. And don't wait until you get a diagnosis of Alzheimer's to get life insurance, or long-term care insurance.
And John Hancock Financial Network, obviously, Robert, it's great to be a partnership.
Absolutely.
Yes, it really is. We believe in the work the Alzheimer's Association does, and we're really pleased that our associates went out and raised this money.
All right, thank you
wonderful.
Very much, Robert. Alice, thank
yes.
you very much for being a part of the NBC 17 Tree of Lights. Thank
Fabulous
you.
Fabulous job. Thank you so much. We appreciate it.
Are we having fun?
Yes.
Well, we have so much other great entertainment tonight, not only Cheyenne Kimball, but a lot of fantastic local entertainment. We want to thank somebody, especially for their service to our country. Not only their great talent tonight, but our friends just down the road at Fort Bragg, a division of the Army, the 82nd Airborne.
Oh, and they're fabulous, fabulous group. Get ready to hear from the 82nd Airborne All-American Chorus.
Hit it.
Christmas, we wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
Glad tidings we bring from all at Fort Bragg. We'll fight for our country and honor our flag. Now bring us a C-130, now bring us a C-130, now bring us a C-130 and bring it right here. Cause we won't jump until we get one, we won't jump until we get one, we won't jump until we get one, so bring it right here. Glad tidings we bring from all at Fort Bragg. We'll fight for our country and honor our flag. We wish you a Merry Christmas, we wish you a Merry Christmas, we wish you a Merry Christmas.
Ho, ho, ho!
And a Happy New Year!
Merry Christmas, everybody!
Hark, count the bells, sweet silver bells, all sing to say, throw cares away. Christmas is here, bringing good cheer to young and old, meek and the bold. Ding dong, ding dong, that is our song, with joyful ring, all caroling. One seems to hear words of good cheer from everywhere, filling the air. Oh, how they sound, raising the sound, o'er hill and dale, telling the tale. Daily they ring, loud people sing songs of good cheer. Christmas is here. Ding dong, ding dong,
Merry Christmas.
Ding dong, ding dong,
Merry Christmas. On, on they send, on without end, their joyful tone to every home. Hark, how the bells, sweet silver bells, all seem to say, throw cares away. Christmas is here, bringing good cheer to young and old, meek and the bold. Ding dong, ding dong, that is our song, with joyful ring, all caroling.
One seems to hear words of good cheer from everywhere, filling the air. Oh, how they pound, raising the sound, or hear the dell, telling the tale, gaily they ring, while people sing songs of good cheer. Christmas is here, ding dong, ding dong,
Merry Christmas,
ding dong, ding dong,
Merry Christmas. On, on they send, on without end, their joyful tone to every home.
Wow. Who know the Army could sing like that? We're very lucky to have them here entertaining us, and every day we're lucky to have them defending our freedoms. They sounded great.
They did. Thank you for your service and for getting us in the holiday spirit. And we'll have more from the All-American Chorus later for NBC 17 Tree of Light special right here at the streets at South Point.
Stay with us. We'll be right back.
Next up, CC and Company offers a special Christmas dance. And Theater in the Park featuring Ira David Wood takes the stage. On Printing an American Home Mortgage.
All right, we are back at the streets at South Point. And Melanie, you know what? I can't think of any way I'd like to ring in the holiday than with 20,000 of my closest friends.
It is fun and it is festive. But we cannot forget the children who may not wake up this Christmas without any gifts. So we want to encourage everyone here that you can make a difference by bringing an unwrapped toy to designated areas right here at the streets at South Point throughout the holiday.
Now, let's get to some more holiday music. Put your hands together for CC and Company.
Merry Christmas, happy holidays. Outside, and all the stockings are hung by the fireside, waiting for Santa to arrive. And all the love will show, 'cause everybody knows it's Christmas time, and all the kids will see the gifts under the tree. It's the best time of year for the family.
It's a wonderful feeling.
Yeah.
To the ceiling.
happiness, cause love is in the air. And all the love will show, cause everybody knows it's Christmas time, and all the kids will see the gifts under the tree. It's the best time of year.
All right, CC and company. I'm with the senior company right here. We've got Addison, and we've got Tiffany, and we've got Sam and Kim. You guys have been dancing for how many years?
Oh, God, 13, 14.
You know, they have danced at UNC and NC State basketball games. They could have used you at the football game today. Would have been nice. Why do you guys dance? What's the purpose?
Simply because we love it. It's a part of our life. We come here. It's a way to express yourself, and just the family here is great.
All right, well, good luck in your future endeavors. They'll be graduating. It looks like you got a lot of other people that are going to carry on their tradition at CC's Dance Company. Great job. Melanie, Wes?
That was fantastic. Wes, you've got some moves like that, don't you?
Yes, thank you. Like, yeah, let's just tell people that. All right, let's switch gears here. From the modern to the traditional, here's a scene from the classic play A Christmas Carol, starring the cast from Theater in the Park. Delayed crowd reaction, but we want to thank those guys. And we also want to say hello to Duke's Children's Hospital. You know, all year long, they work hard to help keep sick children well.
That's right, but it takes donations to help keep the hospital its best. Kim Giornardo shows us how the sale of a home helps a child.
You would never think a for sale sign would mean much, but for the children at Duke Children's Hospital, it means a lot. Each year, dozens of area REMAX agents donate a portion of their sales to the Children's Miracle Network.
The Children's Miracle Network monies that we receive from REMAX and our other national sponsors help us create programs and services that are wonderful for the children, both as an inpatient and as an outpatient and their families.
Karen McClure says the money helps create programs that range from entertainment to educational. Grayson Hodge owns and operates a Children's Miracle Network office. He says he's proud of the work his group is doing.
The recognition comes from Duke itself, and we're very fortunate in our area, I think, to have such a nationally acclaimed children's hospital as Duke as our main benefactor for the funds that we're collecting.
Grayson Hodge, owner and broker of REMAX Preferred, joins us now with a special presentation today for Karen McClure, who is with Duke Children's Hospital, the Children's Miracle Network. Come on, girls, show them what you got.
Thanks, Kim. It's great to be here on behalf of the Children's Miracle Network, the other area REMAX owners, and all the great REMAX agents in our area. We'd like to present this check to Duke Children's Hospital.
All of our REMAX agents and offices are so generous and just so committed to Duke Children's Hospital. We're very grateful. Thank you, REMAX.
Thank you, REMAX. $204,000, folks, to Duke Children's Hospital. NBC 17's Tree of Lights. We'll be right back.
Coming up on NBC 17's Tree of Lights, the King's Choir returns. And later, Cheyenne Kimball in concert. Stay with us. NBC 17 Tree of Lights is sponsored by Panera Bread and SE Systems.
Wes, we're about 40 minutes away, 40 minutes from lighting this beautiful 50-foot Norwegian spruce.
My watch is synchronized, but are you ready for some more music? Let's bring back the King's Choir. This time they're performing I Can Hear the Angels.
Glory to the newborn King, the angels sing.
That was fantastic. Wow, it's got us in the mood for the holiday spirit. That was absolutely beautiful. I have Patrick Anderson here, who is the general manager right here at the Streets at South Point.
And I have Staff Sergeant Balderson with the United States Marines. We'll talk to him in a second.
We are talking about the Toys for Tots, which is a very important organization that gets you have the opportunity to donate toys right here at the Streets at South Point so that other kids out there who are unable to have toys on Christmas can actually get a toy, which is obviously very important. Mr. Anderson, tell us, why did the Streets at South Point decide to take part in Toys for Tots?
Well, we're excited to partner again with the Marine Corps Toys for Tots Foundation. And they do a tremendous effort in our community, and all their work comes back to this community. So if everybody brings in a toy here, it really impacts the places where we live and where we work.
And it's been very successful.
Very, extremely successful.
And Staff Sergeant, let me ask you, the Marines, I mean, ever since I've known, they have been involved with Toys for Tots. When did you guys get started with this?
Well, we're coming up on our 60th year doing it, basically back since 1947.
And why did you guys first get involved? I mean, you saw a need out there, didn't you?
That's right. Our slogan is, every child deserves a little Christmas. And we know there's children out there that are going to wake up on Christmas and don't have a toy. So I need your all's help to get us some toys.
I think we have enough people to get a few toys out here. Bring your toys out here to the Streets at South Point or any location around town and help make some kids' Christmas a great one.
That's right, and we'll be right back in just a couple of minutes with the NBC 17 Tree of Lights right here in the Streets at South Point.
Still to come, Cheyenne Kimball in concert, the 82nd Airborne All-American Chorus, and Santa arrives to help light the NBC 17 Tree of Lights at the Streets at South Point.
Welcome back. Look at this crowd here at the Streets at South Point. About 35,000 people getting ready for the switch to be thrown so we can see the NBC 17 Tree of Lights all lit up. If you can't see the stage and you're out here, make sure you check out one of the several monitors that is out here so that you can enjoy all of the show. Now, we can't forget that Santa Claus will also be here very soon. Kim is in the crowd ready for his big arrival, right, Kim?
You know it, Melanie. I am such a huge Christmas person. Check out our station mascot, NBC 17 Feathers. Woo! You know, I love Woolly Bull, but our mascot is much more colorful. Isn't he? Isn't he a beautiful peacock? I am joined by a lot of good-looking folks up here. We have the Holman and Daniels families from Durham. Thank you for being with us. How do you guys ring in the holidays? What do?
With family, friends, we eat a lot and spread cheer.
Yeah. Are you looking forward to that beautiful tree being lit tonight?
Yes.
What about you girls? Can't wait, I bet, huh?
No.
All right. We have Raul and Raul Davalos from Cary with us. Hello, gentlemen.
Hi, how are you?
I'm great. Happy holidays to you. Why are you here tonight, Raul?
Well, enjoying this time, this wonderful time of the year with all these beautiful people around us.
And you want to tell me, Ben, what you want for Christmas? Because someone might be listening.
A dog.
Woo! All right. Santa, you heard that. I know he's out there. Ben Davalos wants a puppy dog. All right. Let's head it over to Donald and Sharon on the John Hancock story.
That sounds great. Thanks a lot, Kim. Wow, these fans are fabulous. Throughout the evening, 100% tobacco-free schools has been asking teens to commit to not smoking.
That's right, and that commitment means taking a pledge to stay tobacco-free, and many North Carolina schools are doing just that, committing to keeping tobacco off of their campuses.
Right now, 78 out of the 115 school systems in the state ban smoking on campus. This ban not only goes for children, but their parents and educators. Mark Ezel with Tobacco Free Schools says the ban is making a difference on whether a child begins to smoke.
It's important because we know from research that schools that have had a 100% tobacco free school policy for three or more years have 40% fewer smokers than schools that don't. So we know we're making a significant difference.
The North Carolina Health Wellness Trust Fund provides money to keep the program going. It includes a promise where kids pledge not to light up. And that can be tough since 6 in 10 North Carolina kids smoked in 2005.
What's it gonna take?
Tobacco.
Reality.
Unfiltered.
a health and wellness initiative.
And joining us now is Jessica Cosillo with the Health and Wellness Trust Fund. Thank you for joining us, Jessica.
Thanks for having us.
Hey, Jessica, tell us what's in store for 07.
Well, first, thanks to all the kids who signed those pledges tonight. Congratulations.
Good job.
And for 2007, we're going to be collaborating with the Carolina Panthers to make all the kids in North Carolina fit and encourage activity in the classroom. We're also going to open up to a health disparities program to serve underserved populations and minorities in North Carolina because we know it's important. We want to make North Carolina the healthiest state in the nation, and I think we can do it, Donald.
You can do it. Thank you so much.
Fabulous. Thank
you,
Jessica.
Well, again, we are on the John Hancock Financial Network stage, but it's also the stage. That's right. Cheyenne Kimball.
Cheyenne is getting ready to perform a couple more songs.
We're coming right back.
Next.
Woo! Welcome back, everybody, to the NBC 17 Tree of Life. Welcome back. Of course, we're on the John Hancock Financial Network stage, also the stage with Cheyenne Kimball entertaining us tonight.
Oh, very exciting night, isn't it? This is great.
Cheyenne, this isn't the first time you've been to the Triangle. It's probably going to be the best, though, right?
Of course it's the best.
Yes, of course.
Of course. Well, Cheyenne, now you started your day. We're going to talk about some of the things that she did here in the Triangle. You started your day with a tour at NBC 17. Tell us about that. And if you guys look up at the video coming up, you're going to be able to see what she did throughout her day. Tell us about the tour.
You know what? It was so fun. I mean, just taking the tour, getting to see behind the scenes of the new station, and, you know, it was just fun. I got to, you know, meet all the interesting people, the crazy people, may I add.
We're not crazy, are we?
It's good crazy. It's all
I think that was directed at us.
Yeah.
It was.
Possibly. No.
And then after that, you had a chance to go on over to Rex Hospital.
I got to go to the hospital, and I got to hold, like, a six-hour-old baby. Aww. It was so amazing. I got to meet with a lot of little children, and it was so fun. I signed little autographs for them, and they were so cute. Oh, it was so fun. There's a baby. There's a baby.
She's so cute. Very good.
Amazing.
Wonderful experience.
Yes, she'll be incredible.
She'll be a big fan of yours.
Yes.
And then, of course, you had a lot of big fans here earlier in the day.
I did, yes.
And you had a meet and greet, right? And there are some of the fans. You guys are in there. There you go. Some of the fans. Fabulous. Tell us about that.
It was so fun. I got to meet you guys. I mean, come on. I love meeting my fans. They're always so great. We take photos and sign and all that fun stuff. Hopefully they don't think I'm too crazy. I mean, I hope not.
No, everybody's loving this concert. You're doing a fabulous job. And Cheyenne, we're so happy that you're here. And so are the fans. Everybody's very happy to have Cheyenne here.
Thank you very much.
So basically, you don't want to hear us anymore. You want to hear Cheyenne. Let's go. Let's rock it. Let's rock it.
Go Cheyenne.
All right.
Yeah.
guys want to hear another one? All right. By the way, I'm very happy to be here. So is my band. So thank you guys for coming out. Really, it's been awesome. All right, this next song is called Hanging On.
NBC 17's Tree of Lights at the Streets at South Point continues. The 82nd Airborne All-American Chorus returns with a special Christmas musical medley. And Santa makes his arrival.
They're getting louder as it gets closer to the time to light the tree. And we're just moments away from Santa's arrival. And we want to remind everyone here and at home that you could play Santa yourself by just bringing a toy and... And we are back, and we want to remind everyone that we are getting very close to lighting the tree, and that we're also getting very close to Santa's arrival. I want to remind you at home, and of course everyone here, that you can play Santa throughout the entire holiday season by bringing an unwrapped toy down here to the mall or any location around town for Toys for Tots.
That's right. You'll be able to find designated spots right here at the Streets at South Point beginning on Monday. Now, let's listen to the 82nd Airborne All-American Chorus.
Come, 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 come ones in lonely exile here, until the Son of God appears.
Rejoice, rejoice, Emmanuel shall come to you. Certain poor shepherds in fields where they lay, in fields where they lay, keeping their sheep on a cold winter's night that was so deep. Noel, 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 born is the King of Israel.
We three kings of Orient are bearing gifts, we traverse afar, field and fountain, moor and mountain, following yonder star.
Oh, star of wonder, star of night, star of royal beauty bright, westward leading, still proceeding, guide us to thy perfect light. Angels, we have heard. mountains in reply, echoing their joy and strength. Gloria, 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 in Excelsis Dei. Gloria, 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 in Excelsis Dei.
Performers. You can check them out at the Progress Energy Center in November and December. Oh my gosh! Look, everybody! It's Santa Claus! It's the moment we've been waiting for. Santa Claus has arrived! Give a big round of applause for Santa. Have you been good this year? When we come back, we will light the NBC 17 Tree of Lights. Welcome back to the NBC 17 Tree of Lights here at the streets at South Point. We are about 1 minute away before we light this lovely 50-foot Norwegian spruce behind us. Is everybody excited? To help us light this lovely tree, and we're gonna have Bill Ray, Donald Jones, Wes Hohenstein, Sharon Caswell, Kim Gennardo, and of course our special guest we have up here, Cheyenne Kimball, and Santa Claus!
And Mrs. Claus!
And Mrs. Claus! Okay, are we ready? We have so many special guests here. Okay, are we ready for the countdown? It's the moment we've been waiting for. All together now. Thank you so much for everybody. Cheyenne Kimbo, Santa Claus, CC and Company, the King's Choir, and the 82nd Airborne All-American Chorus. Thank you so much for coming out tonight. All of you out here who braved the cold weather to celebrate with us tonight. Thank you so much. Have a happy and safe holiday.